Okay, here we have this beautiful old HOPF violin. It bears two stems, one on the upper back and one inside the body. And unfortunately, it wasn't visible on the first side, but also here. We have a tiny, hardly visible crack. Goes all through here, down here. And on the other side. It is also visible that through the APEC hole here, so, unfortunately, you have to do this. Okay, unfortunately, we've seen it and people do it now. People played it. Okay, therefore we have to put a new piece of maple in. We mark the area. Now it's going to be slightly cut off, and this piece will be fitted in later on. Well, we're going to carve it out, but let me say something to the scroll again. Old HOPF violin. It has here a little X built in. This is to prevent that the A string in particular interferes with the other strings. I've seen that before, but anyway, as you can see, the scroll is grafted as well, so this shows it's quite old violin, which estimates age about mid-19th century, so 1850s on, maybe 1870s. On this part, as you can see on the other side, we played it, the plate will go over the D-pack hole as well. On this side of the violin and this side of the scroll, it just goes over the A-pack hole, which is quite enough. Also, we don't want to go too deep in this case. Okay, anyway, I think the maximum we are going to take off here will be something between half a millimeter and 0.8 millimeters. This coal is grafted. We have to do this quite delicate job very carefully. So now we are so far, let me cut it out so we can put this piece of maple in here. Glue it in here and then we shine it down. And there we go, it's glued and now we have to wait a day or half a day and then we can go on. So here we are on the scroll repair of the HOPF violin again. We are in process, so it needs a little bit finishing, and then comes the other side and then comes the varnishing, the re-varnishing. So here we have the left side plated and meanwhile we put in another piece of maple on the right side of the scroll, which will be carved into shape now, and then the APEC hole will be drilled. So meanwhile we nearly finished. APEC hole is drilled. And the next step will be the varnishing. Okay, now comes the re-varnishing. Therefore we use dragon blood mixed in our varnish. Usually we'll need several layers. Okay, other side. Okay, turn it a little bit, so a few layers are still missing and then we get some transparent varnish on top and it will be polished. Okay, and here we are with our pec case repair at the fine old HOPF violin. This is a very beautiful antique HOPF violin. You would estimate its age around mid-1800s. It has a very nicely flamed one-piece maple back stamped on the upper side HOPF, as well as it's stamped on the inside of the body HOPF, a medium to fine grain spruce front. The violin received new strings, new ebony tailpiece and ebony chin rest, as well as a bridge was newly fitted. The violin is going to be played with an old German violin bow, recently restrung with new silver wrapping and new leather grip.